Hello, my name is Ben Crabb. I do technical sales and support here at Apogee Instruments. I'm here to talk about a tool that we put together to help our users of quantum or PAR sensors to get more accurate measurements under a variety of lighting sources and correct for the spectral errors that may occur. Let's do a little examination of the quantum sensors that Apogee carries. We carry two basic varieties of quantum sensor, our original quantums and our full spectrum quantums. The originals came out a number of years ago. They're a low-cost option that produce very accurate measurements under broad spectrum lights. They have their spectral response drops off a little bit in the red range and the blue range. But they are an excellent choice for most lighting conditions. The tool that we'll go over momentarily is most applicable to these original quantums. The full spectrum quantum has a response that more closely approximates the PAR response, which is 400 to 700 nanometers, which has been defined as the wavelength of light that plants can use for photosynthesis. So this is a look at the spectral responses of those two types of quantum sensors, as well as the PAR response. The PAR response being shown by this black dotted line, and the original quantum response being in the thick black line. You can see that drops off in the red range out here from 655 to 700, and it drops off a little bit in the blue range as well. So if your light emits a lot of light in those portions of the spectrum, the original quantum is going to read a little bit low, erroneously low. The full spectrum is spectral response is indicated by this gold line. You can see that it nearly approximates, very nicely approximates the dashed black line of the official PAR response. And so it's going to provide very accurate measurements under any lighting conditions. Let's move to the tool. It is, here's the page for the tool. We will include this URL in the comments section down below. Let's scroll down and examine it. It's pretty easy to use. The way it works is you just select your sensor and your light source, and this display will update. The green line indicates the spectral response of the sensor. The red line indicates the output of the light. And the dashed black line indicates the official or the defined PAR response, which is 400 to 700 nanometers. And so as we select the different sensor options, we have two different original quantums. One's been calibrated to read most accurately under sun. The other's been calibrated to read most accurately under T5 lights. And then we have our SQ500, which is one of our full spectrum quantum sensors. It's going to read accurately under any lighting conditions. So as an example, what we have selected here is clear sunny day. This is the lighting spectrum that would be expected on a clear sunny day. And we see that our sun calibrated SQ110 original quantum sensor, the expected error on this guy, let's unclick this. Our expected error on this guy is 0%, and the correction factor being 1.00. That just means you take your reading from your SQ110, you multiply it by the correction factor, in this case 1.00, and you get a more accurate PAR reading. Of course, in this particular instance, multiplying by 1, you get the same reading because it's already very accurate. But if you had used this electric calibrated sensor, original quantum sensor, it's the same technology, the same sensing technology, but it's been calibrated to read accurately under T5 lights. Now you take it out in full sun, you measure PAR, and you get a reading that is about 14% lower than it should be. So the tool says apply a correction factor of 1.16. So you take your reading from your SQ120, you multiply it by 1.16, and you get a much more accurate PAR reading. And so that's the way the tool works. And you can scroll through the different preloaded lighting spectra we have in this tool. You can use the arrow keys on your keyboard to go through it quickly if you'd like. And this little rectangle up here will be color-coded yellow if the error is between 5 and 10%, and red if it's expected to be more than 10%, and it'll show those correction factors. One thing to note is that with LEDs, which emit a lot of their light in very narrow spectral ranges, if you use a deep red LED, so the one we have displayed here is a deep red LED with a 668 nanometer peak. Now this is sort of outside of the range of highest spectral sensitivity of the original quantums. So the original quantum sensor just doesn't pick up much of that light very effectively. And so it's reading, I mean, this one says the expected error is -65%, so it's going to be very low. And you can apply that correction factor, but do it with caution, because if the sensor is not detecting much of the light, and you try and correct that, you may not get a really reliable reading. It would be better to get a higher quality sensor, such as a full spectrum quantum. A couple other things to note on this tool is we have this checkbox down here to show correction factor for underwater measurements. This is useful for people who like to measure PAR in their aquariums, for corals and such. When you select this, the display will update and it will show the expected error in air and the expected error in water and correction factors for both situations. So that's how that works. And then we have a final functionality of this tool. You can upload your own custom lighting spectra, or you know, if you don't find your lights on the list here, or you know your spectra, the spectrum of your light is different than what we have loaded here, you can upload your own data. You just click this browse button and you navigate to the CSV file on your machine. It expects the first column to be wavelength expressed in nanometers and the second column to be the light output. And when you do that, then you just select the custom data from CSV file under the light source, and the display will update. In this case, we haven't uploaded any light data, and so it says upload some data. Anyway, what else do we have? I think that's all we have. This tool is under development. We welcome any feedback. This is our email address and our phone number. Please leave any comments down below, and please subscribe to our YouTube channel for more updates from Apogee Instruments. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.